We decided several years ago that the 55X wasn't getting its maximum performance in a Cirrus due to the roll trim cartridge. The roll trim cartridge is Cirrus's answer to flying the control surfaces. And typically with our autopilot, we use an actual roll servo in which we can control the manufacturing and tolerances of. So thus, performance of a 55X is based on our roll servo, not a trim cartridge, which we do not manufacture. So by developing a roll servo, we wanted to maximize the performance of the 55X and the maximum performance out of the SR22. We noticed that a lot of times, especially on an ILS or in GPSS steering, the airplane would do what's known as S-turn on the approach. It would not be a stable approach. So in order to overcome that, we decided that the roll servo was the best answer for that because we can control the production of the roll servo for its tolerances. Cirrus does a fantastic job in building an airplane, but the roll trim cartridge, one varies from one airplane to another, so we don't have the control over that. Thus, airplane performance or autopilot performance is different from one Cirrus to another. The effect is better performance out of the autopilot and the airplane. And that's where I'll ask you, Jim, to tell me what you think about it. Since you have done this in your airplane, you have written the check for this, how do you think it operates and performs your airplane better?
A couple things right off the bat. ILS, the oscillatory stuff that can happen on a hard capture, gone. Zilch. Nada. Really nicely done. On top of that, the hard captures you get with these really acute intercepts, where especially with some of these newer WAS approaches where they're just running these really acute, nasty angles. This thing just cranks on around, does what it needs to do. No shutter, no nonsense. It sets an attitude, it captures, it does it, rolls out. And finally, one of the things I hadn't been told to expect, but I wound up being very pleased with, we did a couple of flights out over the Mojave Desert, low-level stuff or moderately low-level stuff, bright sunny day, and it's turbulent city. You are getting hammered. It's a lot of a workload for a pilot, and it's a severely tough workload for an autopilot. So there's often a tendency to overbank and overcorrect because just about the time the system thinks it's got it right, it's getting hit again. Smoother response, much nicer in the really heavy turbulence, no matter what. Overall, much smoother ride, much tighter captures, much more accurate captures, really nicely done. Serious thumbs up for the roll servo mod. If you're upgrading a much-loved 55X, you got to try this thing. Really nicely done.
Aero TV is brought to you by...
The beauty of the Release 9 system architecture is that you have two fully redundant integrated flight displays. Each has access to all the systems and data. Providing full redundancy and eliminating traditional reversionary modes, Release 9 allows either display to be configured as the PFD. Now your failure modes are much more manageable because you can continue to fly with the same familiar display symbology without the need to relearn composite modes you don't typically fly with. Avadyne's Integra Release 9 is truly the next generation in fully integrated flight deck technology.